Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to be putting the 45 ACP against the 380 in a speed test, okay? So basically I got my two targets over there, and basically I'm going to be dumping the magazines as fast as I can on the targets, and try to just get a sense of how tight the grouping is, and see, you know, if how hard or difficult it is to manage the recoil when you're just trying to unload a magazine. The obvious challenge that I see with the LCP is that the sight's really, really small. So you know, I know from my prior experience with this gun, you know, sometimes it can be hard to pick up those sights. It's also a double action only trigger, so you got that long trigger pull. So that no doubt's also going to be a factor. The 1911, you know, it's a pretty standard gun. Everybody's familiar with it. You know, it's got a really nice trigger. Okay, you know, this is a Taurus PT 1911. You know, it's not a very expensive gun. I think it was like $550 when I got it. Probably that was many years ago. It's probably a lot cheaper now because, you know, gun prices have come down. And this, you know, this 1911, I would say probably has at least 10,000 rounds through it. Okay, and I probably only clean it maybe around, you know, every 500 rounds or so. So you know, it's all original parts. I've never had a problem with this gun. So it's a really good gun. Okay. Let's start with the 380. All right. And again, I'm using an extended magazine because the standard magazines only have 6 rounds, and I wanted to get, you know, basically I wanted to get 8 rounds on target. So we're gonna use the extended one. I know as I was shooting that, I definitely lost the sights while I was shooting, and I can see right here that, there you go, you know, I was aiming up here and I managed to put 2 rounds down here. The rest of them are 1, 2. Okay, so basically I'm at about 5 yards. I've got, I mean, my main spread is about 6 inches, with the exception of these two down here, where I'm fully aware that I lost I lost the sights while I was shooting, okay? And then because it was a speed test, I was trying to go as fast as I can, basically I had to recover those sights while I was shooting, okay? But the 6 rounds are pretty tight over there, you know, that's not bad, I mean, so I'm kind of happy with that. And if I did this again, chances are, you know, maybe I may not lose the sights, you know. But there's no question that the sights on this gun, you know, because they're so small, they are harder to find and to keep. All right, so let's try the 1911 now. About 5 yards. I definitely felt the gun jumping around a little bit more, you know, a little bit more than the 9mm. Even the 40 caliber seemed a little bit more controllable when I shot that. And there's a prior video that you guys can look up on that. And the groupings look like, it looks like it's about, you know, probably a 5-inch spread over here. Yeah, I'll pull these out so you can kind of see them. Mm-hmm. So, this is the 380 on top. Okay, so as we can see, basically, I got a nice grouping over here. And at some point during the shooting, it wasn't necessarily at the end, I think it was at some point in the middle, I lost my sights. And I put 2 down here on the paper down here. And then this is my grouping with the 1911 shooting the 45 ACP, you know, at 5 yards. And basically it's all, you know, looks like it's all within 5 or 6 inches there. Basically the 45 is definitely controllable. I probably had a little bit more of a difficulty with the 380. You know, obviously that's not a recoil issue, okay? Even though The funny thing is that this gun seemed to recoil not quite as much as 1911, but the recoil was actually pretty close. And the reason is because it's such a light gun. So even though it's shooting the much less powerful 380, because the gun itself has less mass, it has less mass to pick up the recoil. You know, whereas the 1911, it's all steel. So that heavier gun is picking up more of the recoil. So because this is a light, the whole bomb of this gun is basically plastic. It's a very light gun. It can be a little bit more difficult to shoot than a larger gun. But anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.